Latvia's vision of the European Union is the union of member states that concentrates on the common good. I think that what we want to see in coming years is a very strong union when it comes to foreign and security policy. It's a union of engaging in free trade with different parts of the world. And it's a union of common values. I think that we very often forget that the union is based not only on single market, not only on the issues of common interest, but also of common values. Well, I think that when we speak about our priorities for the union, especially after Brexit, and as we speak, we don't know what the outcome is going to be, what kind of deal we are going to reach at the end of this process. Our values, our priorities for the future of the European Union is our United Kingdom, resting more integration in the defense sector. I think that the decision of launching permanent structured cooperation in the defense field by the European Union is the right step. Well, obviously we don't want to see any competition with NATO, we don't want to see this structured cooperation as a kind of paperwork and more bureaucracy. We want to see real capabilities for military cooperation, more cooperation in the field of industry, also tackling hybrid warfare issues that my country is particularly interested in. Second is, I believe, we have the window of opportunity to address management of Eurozone. Third, and definitely very important for my country, is that we continue convergence policy within the European Union, because not all of the EU member states are enjoying the same level of living standard. And the sooner we reach that, probably the better it's going to be for those countries that are well off and those countries that are still trying to reach that level of living standard and convergence. Well, obviously, our closest allies are those where our common interest is. And to some extent, I could say that Brexit is bringing new alliances, new groups to tackle some of those common interests I was referring to in the earlier response. First of all, of course, we have very close cooperation within the Nordic-Baltic framework. Scandinavian nations, Baltic nations are very like-minded nations on many issues, be it security, foreign policy, trade issues, single market. One particular issue where I believe we are very like-minded and I would love to see more EU engagement is digital economy and digital single market. Second, we do have developing relations with Benelux countries through different, let's say, discussion forums like Nordic Baltic and Benelux meetings. And I'm very pleased that also after today's discussions with my colleague, Irish Foreign Minister, that we see also that we have a much closer, much more active relations with Ireland. Well, we discussed a lot about our stance on the future of Europe, on Brexit, on Europe's eastern and southern neighborhoods, and I believe that to some extent, when we speak about the Northern Europe, we can include Nordic, Baltic, Benelux countries, Ireland. We want to see as close as possible cooperation with Germany as well. We have also very specific formats talking with Visegrad Group countries on areas of common interest. So we try to find friends everywhere, but of course we see that the Union should function in 27. When it comes to big issues, but of course then discussing a lot of issues, inevitably you get either sectoral or geographical interests that has to be taken into account. As I said, To some extent, Brexit is probably giving new impetus to our bilateral relations. We had a very good discussion about our common interest when it comes to the outcome of the Brexit talks, be it status of nationals, be it financial settlement, and of course we absolutely understand and respect and support the specific situation that Ireland is in. And we agreed that it is in our interest to keep that unity at 27 as close, as strong as possible. Second, yes, that's the future of Europe, and I think that we are like-minded nations on many fronts, so be it development of single market, single digital market or digital economy, be it foreign and security policy, be it also issues that are related to the management of Eurozone. So I find from our earlier discussions, and particularly the talks we had today, that we are very like-minded nations on many fronts. What we want to see is how we can use those regional and sectoral formats I just referred, also involving more discussion with Ireland. We have already very good experience, ministers of finance have met, I don't mean on bilateral, but this regional formation, we have also prime ministers meeting and coordinating some of those issues. So I see the future that it could be the case also before some of very important policy meetings at European level, where we discuss issues, where we form more united position between the Baltic region, Ireland, and Benelux. I think that you have some kind of new grouping emerging here.